Almost every gardener has had the unfortunate experience of dealing with the painful rash of poison ivy, but there are many other plants that can cause itching skin and rashes, known as contact dermatitis. Especially in the summer when we have more of our skin exposed and we're cutting down weeds and hauling plants to the compost pile, we're exposing more of our skin to these plants. Now, not everyone will react to these plants just like with poison ivy, but if you react to one, you might be more susceptible to others as well. Now, many of our common vegetable plants, like tomatoes and squash especially, can cause irritation. Even squash leaves, for some people, cucumbers even. Asparagus, ferns, and artichokes can sometimes cause itching. Usually, the itching subsides quickly with no longer lasting effects, so you might want to pick your figs or your tomatoes with long sleeves and gloves on just to protect your skin. Some of the common perennials that we use in Central Texas, like Lantana, Copper Canyon Daisy, English Ivy, and zexmenia, can also cause rashes for some people. Now, stinging nettles are not a very common weed here, at least not on the west side of town, but they can cause a temporary, about 2 hour long, painful rash. But the plants are edible when they're cooked, and they have a wonderful array of medicinal qualities, so still worth having in the garden. Rue is one of the best-known herbs that can cause severe reactions to the skin. The sap can cause blistering and burns when it is exposed to the sun, so that's one you want to be very careful when you're working around. Angelica and other members of the carrot family, like celery and parsley and lovage, can be irritating for some gardeners. Members of the poinsettia family, like Mexican poinsettia or Texas croton, can cause reactions when the milky sap is on the skin. So when you're breaking that when weeding, you want to be extra careful. Pencil cactus is another common plant that when you cut that and the milky sap drips off, that can be, the sticky sap is very reactive for some people. Now, some people will have reactions to mums and sunflowers, and the common Peruvian lily or alstroemeria, like these, it comes in many beautiful colors and grows here, but it can cause severe reactions, especially for florists who handle it a lot. Daffodils, tulips, and hyacinth bulbs and their sap can cause skin reactions for some. If you're allergic to latex, you may have issues with fig trees or Schefflera plants, which are often grown indoors. If you do have issues, wash your skin well with soap and cool water and stay out of sunlight for a while. A clay poultice may help to reduce irritation as well as aloe vera gel, but some people are allergic to aloe vera as well. For Backyard Basics, I'm Trisha Shirey. Thanks for watching.